Hey everybody, I'm Matt Camp. This week's NXT on USA Network brought us a new number one contender for Finn Balor's NXT Championship and some strong statements ahead of New Year's Evil, which is less than 3 weeks away. It's time for the NXT Injury Report. Kyle O'Reilly and Pete Dunne squared off to see who would face Finn Balor for the NXT Championship at New Year's Evil. And as you might expect from their battles over the last month, this was just as hard-hitting and intense. After a brawl broke out in the ringside area before the match even began, the focus reverted to O'Reilly and Dunne, with both men dishing out both brutal and innovative offense. In the end, O'Reilly earned the victory with a top rope knee to the back of Dunne's neck to become the number one contender. Both men came out of the match with visible bruises and contusions. In the main event, Rhea Ripley and Toni Storm revisited a rivalry that originated in battles over the NXT UK Women's Championship. These days, there's much more dislike between these two major players of the women's division, and that was on full display in the Capitol Wrestling Center. However, it was Raquel Gonzalez who swung the tide when she snatched Ripley off the ring apron and sent her into the post. Storm would go on to hit Storm Zero for the win. As if the loss wasn't bad enough, Ripley once again suffered ear trauma and skin disfigurement similar to what she dealt with in her match against Io Shirai last month. On Facebook Live, minutes before NXT on USA Network began, Indy Hartwell told Wade Barrett she wouldn't need her neck brace anymore and would be facing Shotzi Blackheart later in the night. Of course, the Way had to make their presence known during the match, and while Candice LeRae had the referee distracted, Hartwell got the green hair trophy from Austin Theory. However, the referee saw Hartwell use the trophy on Blackheart, which caused a disqualification. The attack with the trophy continued, and Hartwell assisted LeRae with a wicked stepsister on Blackheart to finish the job. Unfortunately for the Way, we can exclusively report the trophy did suffer some damage, but it was taped up and is considered day-to-day. Next week, the countdown to New Year's Evil on January 6th continues, as we'll see The Way present a very Gargano Christmas. Plus, Jake Atlas takes on Isaiah Swerve Scott and the return of Bronson Reed. Catch all of the action next Wednesday on the USA Network at 8, 7 Central.